Hello guys and welcome back for another video on the Nashorn restoration. In this video I will be showing you the welding of the cradle system. Most welds that I use in this system is corner welds, inside and outside corners. At the end of the video I will be talking about things I did in this video, but also things that are coming next. The weld I'm doing here is an outside corner weld, and later on it has to be grounded flush and also rounded off so that it will look like a bent part. So it needs to be filled up completely so I have enough material to grind flush. When I'm welding I sped up the recording so that it doesn't take very long, but you can still see the entire process. For doing the weld on this outside, it's inside corner weld because the bottom plate is sticking out a little bit, but because the edge is very close I need to turn down the amperage to make sure the welding doesn't fall off the plate. If you have any questions on the welding process, you can leave a comment and I will try to get back to you as soon as possible. Of course you have to keep the nozzle clean in between welding because the welding splatter is going to fill up the nozzle and then the gas will disturb the welding process, especially the covering gas. Next I'm going to start some welding on the inside, so the inside plate needs to come out and you can hear the difference in welding. The settings are a lot higher, so it has more of a hissing sound. If you're interested in helping the project, you can buy merchandise, send us an email at nashornfund@gmail.com and we will send you an order form. You can see the little strengthening bracket, and there was a big gap in it, so I did several weldings. And to not get the material too hot, I let it cool down and did some other welding in between. The can you see me use in the background is tip dip. It is to keep the nozzle clean and also to reduce welding splatter. This is the outside corner weld that I'm doing for making this part look like it's bent sheet metal instead of two pieces welded together. So again, on these welds the amperage settings are a bit lower so that you get a nice round weld. Got most of this part welded now. These outside corners still need to be ground in a way that's round to resemble the folded metal. Inside is completely welded. This corner too also has to be rounded off. This one too. And the inside sheet still needs to be put in, but also over there need bushing for the pivot shaft for the traverse. But I still need to get the bearing in and get the part turned on a lathe, and then I can weld it in. If that's in, the floor plate can go back in and be finished welded. Then on the sides, this one and this one, I need through holes, quite a bunch, from 13 millimeters up to 100 millimeters. On this side will be a big hole, and you have a tube with a shaft, drive shaft, go in, and then with the pin, with the gear like this, and that's for the elevation. And from that side will, on an angle, will be a tube for the drive shaft, and then over here there will be a gear going down for the traverse. About the grinding, hope you can see it, this is a weld without grinding. It needs to be rounded off like it would be a bent metal. The first step is using a grinding disc and then flattening these two surfaces. So using this disc. It's a 6mm disc, a quarter inch, and then the same with the same disc rounding off the corner. It's a bit difficult to see. And then later with the sanding disc, cleaning it off and getting it smooth. And then when it's painted, it's very difficult to see if it's rounded after welding or if it's bent steel. Of course, it's still a little bit irregular, but yeah, if you don't know it, you won't see it. And this is the sanding disc I'm using. It's a single disc. You have them also with multiple discs, multiple sandpapers like this one. But yeah, these get rounded off and the other ones stay flat, so I like the other ones better. Looks completely different now. All the corners are smooth. I've taken the welding spatter off as much as possible. This looks now like a bent sheet instead of welded. Next job is marking the holes that I need to drill. We have now a magnetic drill, so I can stick it to the side, but yeah, because the drill is heavy, I will throw the part on the side and then put it on top. It's easier to position, especially alone. So now I'm gonna mark the holes.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell for more. See you the next time.